say you wanna go to the Polo Club.
All right, here we are. We are going to see John McCain today at the Cleveland Clinic. And we're parked a couple of blocks away because you can't park anywhere near the Cleveland Clinic because we're in the worst neighborhood in Cleveland.
So let's go, let's go. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Let's go, Polo Club.
Sporting the blue blazer and the khakis because it's, you know, it's time to look like a Republican. Smith's Barbershop, seen better days. There it is. We crossed the street from one America into the other America, John Edwards.
Lots of pretty girls at the Polo Club, whoa, like the big black boots and the tight white suits. Pretty people and the fancy things, big hats and diamond rings. I would say that's just your style. Let's go, let's go.
And the props are happily seated.
Infant born with complex congenital heart disease to survive and thrive, and a vigorous young boy was able to survive an awful accident. Families also place a high value on quickly getting sent.
But I'd like to give you this researcher, one of your people. And also I wanted just to say in passing that I have switched from drinking wine to drinking beer.
Let's go.
I'd just like to understand is, and I think when we're there, we're so much more aware of the issue. The number of healthcare dollars that are getting quote sucked up by illegals. What's happening on the border towns in Arizona, Texas, New Mexico, certainly. I mean, that's a disaster there.
Do you have any comment on the North Carolina ad regarding Barack Obama's pastor?
Not at all. I have no comment.
Do you expect to use Barack Obama's pastor as an issue in the fall?
There'll be plenty of issues in the fall that'll have more impact on Ohioans than that issue.
So are you saying you would hope that Republicans don't use that issue?
I would hope that Republicans would deal with the issues that are important to the American people.
Is Reverend Wright one of them?
I don't believe that Reverend Wright is one of them right now.
Right now?
Who knows? You can't. I don't have a crystal ball, so I can't tell you what the fall brings.
Great. Thanks.
Yes.
You did. You valet parked. Did you valet park?
Yeah.
You did.
For $10?
That's how much it costs?
Yes. Isn't that terrible?
Who are you?
I'm just a guy with a video camera, that's all. Yep. Says valet park for the McCain event? Something else. You got a valet park for a Republican event, isn't it something? Oh, I don't know. I kind of thought free parking would be good. Valet park for the McCain event?
Yes, we did.
You did? Don't you think free parking would be better?
Yeah. It's at a discount.
Yeah? Is that a discount?
Yeah.
Thanks. Did you valet park for the McCain event?
I did.
You did. All right. Back to the other America. Bye, Intercontinental Hotel. Goodbye. Literally 1 minute away. On our way to the other America. So I wanted to ask John McCain about who pays for his health care, since it's probably the taxpayer, and his wife is worth $100 million. I wanted to ask him if he thought that was at all Dickensian. Because I feel like sometimes I'm in a Charles Dickens novel, like David Copperfield or something, where a doctor at the Cleveland Clinic literally asked John McCain if sick people could be charged something from their insurance company for being sick because they don't take care of themselves. Somehow, none of this really makes sense. But then, I see a yard sign like that, and I somehow feel better. Hey, John McCain, I would have liked to have asked that question. Everybody saw me raising my hand, but just wonder who's paying for your health care. Because if it's the taxpayers, it's people who live in this neighborhood who pay more tax than that nonprofit hospital over there, which pays no tax, giving you money so that that money can go to that hospital to keep you well. So you know John McCain was giving a speech over here.
Yeah, he was giving some kind of symposium on health care.
Do you know that the taxpayers pay for his health care?
Yeah. Pretty much.
You know that Cleveland Clinic doesn't pay any taxes?
Yes, I do.
Do you live in this neighborhood?
Yes, I do, and I know more about that than I would care to even think about telling.
Do you?
Yeah.
Do you pay taxes?
Yes, I do. I work every day.
You pay more taxes than your neighbor, the Cleveland Clinic?
I'm sure I do.
And some of those go to pay for John McCain's health care.
I wouldn't doubt that. I wouldn't doubt it one bit.
Does that upset you at all?
No, because that's kind of the way things are.
You know, we can change that.
How?
See that Obama sign over there?
Yeah. Well, I'm for Obama. I have no problem voting for him, and I've been a registered voter since I was 18. As a matter of fact, the house I grew up in was right over here. It's torn down.
What happened to it?
We moved away.
And they tore down your house?
Yeah.
Why?
Probably because the next set of people that moved in it didn't take real good care of it, or maybe nobody moved in it. I have no idea.
Meanwhile, the Cleveland Clinic gets bigger all the time.
Yeah, I know that. And we can't get not one city official to stop them from doing what they're doing. The politicians have pretty much sold out this community to Cleveland Clinic.